Days ahead seem hopeless. No joy can be found.
Like the searching wise men looking for some hope.
Then amidst Christ's darkness, there a star has shone.
We have seen His star shining from afar, twinkling at His light, taking from our lives so light. What a joy does this find! Give our hearts the hope so bright. Our hope in our Lord Jesus Christ.
We may now our suffering, troubled and in pain, but the star of Jesus in our heart we claim.
Let us share
atong ginapuy-an.
Kalamidad, kagubot, makalilisang nga mga balatian, nagapuno o kahadlok sa kasing-kasing sa katawhan, uban ni ining tanang panghitabo, diin man ang tao makakaplag o pakigdait, kalinaw o kalipay.
Gini malisang ang inyong mga kasing-kasing. Tumuo kamo sa Dios o tumuo usab kamo kanako. Mao'y imbitasyon ni Kristo. Alang kanatong tanan.
Kung ang atong pagtuo sa Dios makapahanaw sa atong mga kahadlok, sa unsa man nga paagi nga kita makatubo sa atong pagtuo diha kaniya?
Unsa nga masad ang atong tuhan aron mahanaw ang atong makabalaka?
Ang Central Philippine Union Conference nag-andam og mga pulong sa paglaom og kasiguruhan alang kanimo gikan sa balaang pulong sa Dios nga nagadala sa maayong balita sa tunga sa maggubot nga kapanahunan.
Kami malipayon nga magaimbitar kaninyo sa pag-uban kanamo ni ining CPUC for Christ Season 2, I Will Go, nga pag-aablihon sa pinasahi sa atong pinalangga nga presidente sa Seventh-day Adventist World Church, si Elder Ted Wilson. Og pagapadayunon kini sa atong mga magbubuhat gikan dinhi sa atong union sulod sa napulo ka mga gabii. And also, we would like to encourage all the care groups throughout the Union Territory to join us in this special evangelistic series.
Ubani kami sa pagkaplag o paglaom og kasiguruhan ni ining programa CPUC for Christ Season 2, I Will Go, dinhi lang sa Hope Channel Central Philippines, ang telebisyon nga makapausab sa imong kinabuhi.
Life and just believe things will turn out the way it should be. As I wake up each day, I can't seem to deny the emptiness. There's none in this world that satisfies me. And then he said that there's one who can feel the longing as I feel in my heart. As you struggle with life, all I can do is pray that you will see that God has his plan for you and for me. As I wake up each day, I will constantly send a fervent prayer.
Say sa akong pagkatawanon at tunay kaluyahan. Usahin makunda na duwala na'y umang utak sa pagsulay o banan sa
brothers and sisters. Welcome to our CPUC I Will Go launching. And so before we start our program, we are going to learn our CPUC theme song, We Proclaim.
The gospel message of this generation we proclaim. God's lavish grace and His divine salvation we proclaim, we proclaim. To the mission fields and to the cities
Morning greetings to all our brothers and sisters in Christ. For those who are watching us live in Facebook, greetings to all of you from Central Philippine Union Conference. For your information, brothers and sisters in Christ, we are live in Facebook and in National TV. So I would like to encourage everyone to please share this live program to your friends so that they will also be blessed by this special event of CPUC. Sa ating mga kapatiran na nanonood ngayon sa ating programa sa Romblon Adventist Mission, magandang umaga sa inyong lahat. Welcome sa programa natin. Sa atong mga kauturan dira sa West Visayan Conference, sa atong mga kauturan sa Negros Occidental Conference, maayong aga sa inyong atanan. And of course, sa atong mga kaigsunan in Negros Oriental Secure Mission, nga naga tanaw sa atong programa niini nga kabuntagon o sa atong makaigsunan sa East Visayan Conference o sa Summer Adventist Mission o labaw sa tanan, no, sa atong makaigsunan dinhi sa Central Visayan Conference nga mong atong host conference niini atong pinasahi nga programa niini kabuntagon mayong buntag kaninyong tanan. And to all the institutions of Central Philippine Union Conference, welcome to CPUC for Christ Season 2 Launching Program. I would like to welcome all of you and to those who are joining us here in the gymnasium. Our live audience here in Adventist Academy Cebu, good morning to all of you. After my part, we will be singing our theme song, We Proclaim, together with the Adventist International Symphony Orchestra. After the theme song will be the opening prayer by Pastor Charles Nogra, our CVC Executive Secretary. Then, a special music to be offered to God by the Shalom. And the introduction to the speaker will follow by Pastor Daniel Trasso, the CVC President. He will introduce to us our speaker from Southern Asia Pacific Division. Then after that will be the message and the special music by the Better Men. Then we will have the part two of this event, the moments of music by the storytellers, the Better Men, and Ivan Sinyuk Rikermi. The processional will follow, and the recognition and introduction by our CPUC President, Pastor Agapito Catani Jr. The special music will follow by the AAC Harmonic Youth with ISO. Then the message of our General Conference of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, Elder Ted Wilson, to be followed by the Song of Rejoicing, which is the Alleluia Chorus with the ISO. Then the Prayer of the Commitment by Ambassador Bienvenido V. Tijano. Then there will be a baptism, my dear friends, brothers and sisters in Christ. We will be celebrating the victory of the gospel to the hearts of these people who accepted Christ as their personal Savior. They will show to us their commitment to the Lord in a form of baptism. After that will be the giving of plaque of appreciation by Pastor Elmer Pagunsan, our CPUC Ministerial Secretary. Then the recessional. And after that will be recognition of our visitors. So my dear friends, I would like also to recognize our song leaders this morning who will be leading us in our songs of praise, Michelle Nogra and Rina Joy Mahinay. And our pianist is Megan Galgao. Hinaot mga kaigsunan nga ang Diyos magahatag kanatog panalangin nining atong pinasay nga programa sa lahat nating mga kapatid na nanonood ngayon, may you will also be blessed where you are right now sa ato nga programa CPUC for Christ Season 2 Launching Program. Welcome everyone.
Pabilin ta sa pagtindog at pagidog ko atong ulos patungko. Gamhanan o balaan namong Diyos na sa mga langit. Salamat sa gasa sa kinabuhi na walay katapusan diha kang Hesukristo. O sa pribilhiyo sa pagsaksi niining makasaysayon nga kaagi sa iglesia ang pagbisita diri sa Sugbo sa among presidente sa General Conference nga si Elder Ted Wilson, o mga kaubanan sa buhat sa GC, EWR, o ISSD. Labi na usab ang presensya ni Pastor Bienvenido Mergal nga maghahatag sa imuhang mensahe niini nga kabuntagon. And now, O Father, please pour unto us your Holy Spirit as we start this program, as we hear your words, as we celebrate your goodness, towards the launching of the CPUC for Christ Season 2 in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
ang atong magsusulti, mga igala, mga kaigsuonan, mga kauban ko sa buhat, usa ka pribiliyo sa matag usa ka nato ang makabati kaniya, gikan siya sa Salcedo Eastern Summer, pito katuig siya nga nagpangabudlay ingon nga district pastor sa East Visayan Mission nga karon East Visayan Conference. Siya Jewish pastor, Bible teacher, Theology Department Dean, Vice President for Student Affairs, Vice President for Academic Affairs, and President sa Central Philippine Adventist College sa Murcia, Bacolod. Sulod sa 16 og tunga ka mga katuigan. Ugon niya, nabalhin siya ngadto sa Adventist International Institute of Advanced Studies. Siyam katuig siya ingon associate professor, nahimong full-time professor o chairperson, professor in Applied Theology Department. Then, siya lang, usa ka tao na dunay gihatag sa Dios kaniyang supported o matinabangon kayong asawa, kaabag niya sa kalampusan sa buluhaton, nga mao si Dr. Vicky Mergal, nga mao atong Assistant Vice President for Academic and Dean Graduate School sa Adventist University of the Philippines. Doon na sila'y tulog ka mga anak. Presente siya ang ato nga Vice President for NDR, IEL, sa Southern Asia Pacific Division o ato nga patilinghugan ang pulong gikan sa Dios pinaagi kaniya ni Dr. Benvenido Mergal.
Mayong buntag sa tanan natong mga kaigsoonan ug mga kagalaan nga niya karon ang tambong nining usag talagsaon nga programa nga kita pagabisitahon sa atong mga pangulo gikan sa atong General Conference. Salamat Pastor Traso sa imong pagpailaila. Og salamat usab sa mensahe sa awit nga nagapahinumdum kanato sa gugma sa Dios. Nining kabuntagon, mga kagalaan o mga kaigsoonan, ako nalipay tungod nining usa ka programa nga inyong gihimo karon mao ang launching sa CPUC for Christ 2 nga kini gisugdan pila ka mga tuig. I think it was in 2016-2017 sa diha nga bag-o pa ko sa NDRIEL. So salamat Pastor Quinto sa padayon nga promotion sa atong programa sa Nurture Discipleship Reclamation Integrated Evangelism Lifestyle. Akong gipalipayan ang atong mga pangulo dinhi sa Central Philippine Union Conference sa inyong leadership ug suporta sa atong buluhaton. Mga kaigalaan o mga kaigsoonan, ang CPUC sumala sa gisulti ni Pastor Quinto, ini nagasimbolo sa committed people and united for Christ. O kini napakita ninyo sa atong mga naglabay ng mga kinkinyo. Niining takna ha, sa pipila ka mga minuto, akong ihatag kaninyo unsa pagkamaayo ang Dios sa iyang buluhaton dinhi sa Southern Asia Pacific Division, ilabi na sa CPUC for Christ. Mga kaigalaan o makigsunan, akong basahon ang Ephesians 5:15 at 17. Mauni kinatumyan sa akong mensahe ngay gahatag nining kabuntagon. Be very careful then how you live not as unwise but as wise. Kinahanglan ko no nga maging maalamon kita sa pagkinabuhi. Unya, making the most of every opportunity. Atong himuon ang tanan natong mahimo, mga opportunities nga gihatag sa Ginoo, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. May kailangan magigsunan sa dilipagumuad to ni Anang Dapita. Atong hinumduma nga ang atong Southern Asia Pacific Division, aduna siya ay gitawag missional focus. O ang missional focus nato, nakuha nato sa misyon ni Kristo sa Lucas 19:10 o sa Mateo 28 versikulo 19. Mingon din eh, He came to seek, save, o niya mato ta sa Mateo 28:19, to disciple. Go and make disciple. So may galaan ang atong focus sa Southern Asia Pacific Division, dili lamang geographical na naa ang atong headquarter diha sa Silang. Kundili ang atong focus, yes, I will go in seeking, saving, discipling. That is, I will go SSD. O ang atong tumong tuyo, mga kigalaan o mga kigsunan, sumala sa Biblia, mao nga gusto nato nga ang matag-usa makakaplag sa kaluwasan o sa diha na masulod sila sa iglesia, sila mutubo sa ilang spirituhanon na kinabuhi, o sila mahimong willing to suffer, committed for Christ, o niya mga lagad sila kang Ginoong Jesus, o niya mahimo silang mga disipulo, o niya ang tumong o tuyo sa iglesia. Mahimo ngayon nga mahingpit ang mga tumutuo nini alang sa lupuluhaton sa ministeryo, o niya ang tibuok nga lawas sa iglesia. Mahimo kiniyon sa malig-on. Mga kaigalaan o mga kigsunan, niining kinkinyong aduna kita'y kitawag nga framework, modelo kung unsaon nato ni paghimo. The first one, atong tumungog tuyo nga atong mapalig-on ang spirituality sa atong mga kaigsunan. We want them to become spiritually mature. And then, sunod, kung sa diha nga nadulot na sila sa espirituhanon nga kinabuhi, ang sunod niya na, mga kaigsunan, nga sila mumantala sa mayong balita, maunang gitawag, making disciples to reach the world, maunang atong mission, I will go. O niya, the manner, kung saan nato ni paghimo, maunang gitawag nato, total member involvement. O ang mga pamaagi, kung saan nato ni, mao ang gitawag, metodo ni Kristo, o the means, mao na atong small groups or care groups nga diin magilano wa kay sunan na kitay daghan mga care groups dinhi sa CPUC. O the motivating and the mobilizing power walay lain kundili ang balaang espiritu kat kanunay mga duso kanato sa buluhaton sa Ginoo. May galaan og makigsunan, as I transition from the NDRIAL to the education department, siguro nahibalo na mo kung unsay linungtara ni atong nominating committee sa SSD. I was elected as the education director for the next quinquennium. Tungod kay aduna kitay buluhaton diha sa atong edukasyon, sa atong mga eskwelahan. Apan sa dili pa kumuadto niya na, I would like to share to you that right now ang Dios nagapanalangin kanato sa daghang mga small groups sa atong Southern Asia Pacific Division. Nagsugod kita sa 2016 with only 13,611. O niya pagka 2017, nahimong 19,574. O niya sa 2018, sa dihang aduna kita'y i-proclamar ng evangelism year, kini nahimo nga 32,897. Pagka 2019, nahimong 35,015. O niya, may galano magigsunan, may os-os kini sa 2020 tungod sa pandemic, na himo kining 27,642. Apan nalipay kita, nga sa diha na na-establishar ang atong NDRIAL committee sa atong mga kaiglesyahan, kini mitubo o karon aduna kita'y 37,574 ka mga care groups. May galano magigsunan, it's really exciting to witness kung giyon sa kining atong mga care group sa paghimo sa buluhaton sa Ginoo. O ang atong care group seminars mga galaan o mga kigsunan, this year 2021 aduna 8,023 o ang atong number of care group evangelism so far the highest niining tuiga 2021 nga miabot og 44,349. You can see the excitement of our people involving in evangelism. Mga kigalaan o mga kigsunan, malipay ko sa pag-report kaninyo nga sa 2016 naduna kitay 80,680 nga baptism, o niya sa 2017 naduna kitay 78,762, and then sa 2018 naduna kitay 126,293. Kay mao kini ang gitawag year of evangelism. O niya sa 2019 miostos kini gamay, o niya sa 2020 bisan pa sa pandemics mga kigalaan, wa gyud nga mapugni ang buluhaton sa Ginoo. Kini nagapadayon kita nakabautismo og 99,444. O mga kigalaan mga malipay kita nga sa 2021 as of October aduna na kitay 102,095 souls. We are expecting nga by the end of this year makaabot kita sobra mga 110 sa diha nga mahuman kining atong CPUC for Christ kanang gitawag Journey with God o guban pa nga mga gihimo sa atong mga unions nga evangelism. That's the blessing of the Lord. O niya, ang atong porsinto sa involvement sa care group niadto mga 26% lamang, apan karon miabot na og 32% ang atong involvement diha sa care group nga involvement. Mga galaan o mga kaigsunan, Psalms 115:1, now unto us, O Lord, not unto us, but into thy name give glory for thy mercy and by thy truth sake. Kinintanan, atong ihatag ngadto sa atong makagagahom ang pagdaig tungod kay gipanalanginan ang iglesia sa mga kalag nga diin niining kinkinyong sobra o mga 500,000 members nga diin nahimong membro sa Adventista del Septimo Dia. Nining taknaha muanto ko sa pagpahinomdong ni Apostol Pablo. Nagaingon siya, be very careful then how you live, not as unwise but as wise. As wise. Naay tulo ka mga butang na importante nato nga hinumduman. Yan ang teksto. The first one, understanding God's will. The second one, be careful the way we live. And then the third one, making the most in every opportunity. Unsay kabubuton sa Dios? 1 Thessalonians 4:3, nagaingon din eh, for is the will of God, even your sanctification. Ang kabubuton sa Dios, mga hinigugma ko nga mga kaigalaan o mga kaigsunan, mao nga kita mabalaan diha sa Ginoo. That's the priority in our life. Unya, kinahanglan mo sabuta unsay direksyon sa atong kinabuhi. We need to be wise. Galatians 6:7 says again on, therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers. The way we live, if we want to be wise, kanang gitawag paghinigugmaay sa matag-usa, pag-inaghatay sa matag-usa, those are things na diin makahimo kanato nga malamon sa pagkinabuhi. Unsa pa? Mga higalaan o mga kaigsunan, Daniel 12:3, nagaingon, those who are wise will shine like the brightness of heavens, and those who lead many to righteousness. Spirituality sa itong kinabuhi will make us wise. And then, when we witness for Christ, CPUC for Christ will make us wise, bringing people to the righteousness of God. Mga kaigalaan o mga kaigsunan, there is that urgency. Atong nibaluan ang atong kapanahonan karon nga din maoni siguro ang katapusang hugna sa atong kasaysayan. makita nato ni sa atong palibot. So there is that urgency, there is that urgency. Mao na ang gitawag sa John 4:35 to 36. Do you not see there are still 4 months and then comes the harvest? Usahay na ipaglangan-langan nato, may galaan ba? Let us commit ourselves. I will go for Christ because there is that urgency. And in this urgency, the situations that we are facing today, atong nakita ang mga dagko ng mga pagkabalhin-balhin, the changes of time. There is what we call uncertainty of our time. Daghan mingon, wala siguro tay paglaom, wa tay kasiguruhan, na ay daghang mga kausaban sa atong kinabuhi. Pero ang mga gilano magigsunan, hinumdumi. Whenever there is change, whenever there is uncertainty, there is always an opportunity. Amen? Nahitabok na, may galaan. Satan was trying to prevent the gospel to be shared to the world sa diha nga miabot ang coronavirus. But friends, I would like to tell you that Satan cannot prevent his work. Because the more we are confined in our offices and our homes, the more we share the gospel through the Zoom. O kini, nilungtad, ngagto sa daghang mga katawhan, nga diin, nasibot sa pagtuon sa balaan ng kasulatan. So when there is a change and whenever there is uncertainty, there is an opportunity. But remember, dili sa yun ang buluhaton sa Ginoo. Niya ang ingon ni Mrs. Ellen G. White sa Christian Service. There are stormy times before us na ay mabagyuhon na panahon na mabot ka nato. But let us not utter one of unbelief or discouragement. Dili kita magsulti ni isa kapulong sa pagkaluya. Let us remember, atong hinumduman nga kita nagadala sa mensahe aron sa pagunsa. To heal a world filled with sin-sick souls. Mao na atong role, mga gilaan o mga kingsunan. We bear a message of healing. Unsa pa'y gisingon ni Mrs. Ellen G. White? Pasalig ka nato. Yes, sometimes. Muingon ta nga, unta, mubalik ta sa atong normal na situation. Aron ang iglesia makahimo sa iyang buluhaton. Pero niya ay gingon ni Mrs. Ellen G. White sa Christian Service page 158. Nagingon siya, the work which the church has failed to do in a time of peace and prosperity. Ang napakyas ng buluhaton sa iglesia sa panahon sa kalinaw o sa pag-uswag nini, iyakining paghihimuon diha sa makalilisa nga panahon in a most discouraging makaluya nga panahon. Mga galano, mga kaigsoonan, this is the promise from the Lord. This is the promise from the Lord. Ngano nga kita makiguban, makikuyog nining CPUC for Christ. Tungod kay aduna kita espesyal nga buluhaton niyang ingon ni Mrs. Ellen G. White sa Testimonies Volume 7 page 19. Ningon siya, in a special sense, Seventh-day Adventists have been set in the world as watchmen and light bearers. I like that very much. To them has been entrusted the last warning. Kanila gisalig, gihatag ang katapusan ng mensahe alang yatong kalibutan na hapit na mawala. On them is shining a wonderful light. Diha kanila niya ang kahayag gikan sa pulong sa Dios. They have been given a word. Gihatagan sila sa buluhaton sa usa ka sulimne nga buluhaton, the proclamation of the first, second, and the third angels' messages. Ang paghatag sa mensahe sa nahiuna, ikaduha, o ikantulo ng mga mensahe sa mga bulod, mga manulunda. And then the last part, naging unini, there is no other work of so great importance. Wala kayo'y mahinungdanon pa nga buluhaton. And then, nagingon din eh, they are to follow, they are to allow nothing else to absorb their attention. Wala untang mga butang nga diin makakuha sa atong attention gikan nining buluhaton sa Ginoo. Mga kaigalano mga gison, we are special people. Mao na nga, we have CPUC for Christ. Mga kaigalano mga gison, there is joy when we involve ourselves in the work of God. Mao nang kalipay sa mga Adventista del Septimo Dia, why they are not hesitant to participate in God's work. Kini ang ingon ni Mrs. Ellen G. White, when we engage with all our hearts in the work, sa diha kuno nga makiglambigit kita sa buluhaton sa Dios, we are closely allied to the angels, duol-duol kita ngadto sa mga manulunda. We are co-workers with the angel, magbubuhat kita kauban sa mga manulunda, and with Christ og ni Kristo. And there is sympathy with heaven with us. Naay espesyal nga kaluoy ang ihatag sa Dios alang kanato. Holy, elevated sympathy, balaan og kinihataas nga simpatiya sa Dios alang kanato. And then we are brought little closer to heaven. Sa diha nga makigduyog kita sa buluhaton sa Ginoo, kita kuno maga paduol, maga kahaduol ngadto sa langit. A little closer to the angelic host, a little closer to Jesus. Then the conclusion, Mrs. Ellen G. White, being on, let us engage in this work with all our energies. Makiglambigit kita diha sa kusog sa atong pagtuo niining maong buluhaton. So may kalano mga kiksunan, karong kabuntagon. As you have this launching CPUC for Christ, akong ihatag ang sugo sa anghel ngadto sa mga disipulo. Mingon ang anghel, go, stand and speak to the people in the temple the whole message of life. Kining sugo sa anghel, may galaan, alang kanato ng mga disipulos, manglakat kita, ihatag nato ang mensahe, the three angels' message, and this is the message of hope. This is the message of life. Mga kailan o mga kaigsunan, niininkin kinyong, I will go. Mingon si Mrs. Ellen G. White, our watchword is to be onward, ever onward. O sa diha nga kita mudasdas sa buluhaton sa Ginoo, ang mga manulunda sa langit, makiguban ka na to aron sa pag-andam o mga opportunities, mga influences o guban pa aron ng buluhaton sa Ginoo kini mahuman. Unsay pasalig sa Dios? Exodus 33:14, ang pasalig sa Dios, the Lord said, I will go with you and I will give you victory. Sa diha kuno nga moingon ta, I will go, CPUC for Christ. Speak the whole message of truth and life. Ang saad sa Dios nagaingon, ako makiguban kaninyo o ako maghatag kaninyo o kadaugan. May galaan o magigsunan, the closing statement na akong ihatag kaninyo, gikan ka Mrs. Ellen G. White sa Testimonies, Volume 6, page 24, nagaingon siya, a crisis is upon us. Niya kita sa pinakalisod nga panahon. Niya kita sa pinakalisod nga panahon. A crisis is right upon us. We must now, by the Holy Spirit, proclaim the great truth for these last days. Pinagi sa balaan ng Espiritu, atong imantala ang mensahe sa kamatuuran niining katapusan ng mga adlaw o pinagi sa iyang pag-iya. Siya mag-aandam sa dalan alang sa buluhaton ng paghahumanon. O niya muhatag siya mga opportunities, channels of working, as his people are watching the indications of his providence and stand ready to cooperate with him, they will see a great work accomplished. May galano magigsunan mo ng pasalig kanato nining kabuntagon. Again, let us strengthen our spirituality, ang atong espirituhanon na kinabuhi. And then, tumano nato ang kabubuton sa Dios for the edifying, for the sanctification of His people. O niya, makigpahat kita sa buluhaton sa Ginoo, CPUC for Christ, ESSD for Christ, reach the world, I will go. O ang Dios, maghatag sa iyang balaan nga Espiritu,
Maghatag ka natog daghang mga opportunities. Maghatag ka natog daghang mga impluensya. Maghatag ka natog daghang mga resources. Maghatag ka natog kagahom. Aron kita magmalampuson sa buluhaton sa Dios. The only way is to cooperate with the three highest powers in heaven. Munang ingon ni Mrs. Ellen G. White, we are to cooperate with the three highest powers in heaven. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and these powers will work through us. Sa diha di ay nga makigdugtong kita sa gahom sa balaan ng Espiritu, sa Amahan o sa Anak. Kita kuno, hatagan sa kagahom o kita mahimong maging bubuhat kaupod ni Ginoong Jesus. May galaan o makigsunan, ang Diyos nagatawag nining kabuntagon. Ang importante lamang mao ang atong pagdedikar sa atong buluhaton sa Diyos. Niya ang ingon ni Mrs. Ellen G. White. Mingon siya, to everyone who offers himself to the Lord for service, bisan kinsa nga iyang itahan ang iyang kaugalingon alang sa buluhaton sa Ginoo, withholding nothing, so walay paghukon-hukon, is given power of attainment of measureless results. Siya hatagan sa kagahom nga diin walagyoy masarangan. Let us claim this promise. Measureless results possible. O kung ato ka nang himoon, may galaan, there is a blessing. There are blessings of engaging ourselves in the work of God. Niya, ang mga panalangin, we will have more grace from God as we involve in God's work. Romans 5:20. We will have more glory. We can glorify His name as we involve ourselves in His work. We will have more honor. Hebrews 3:3. We will have more love to our fellow men. Philippians 1:9. We will have more fruits. Mamunga kita. Diya sa gugma. We have more joy. Na kita'y dakong kalipay. Diya sa buluhaton sa Ginoo. And then, we will be able to give the honor and the glory to Him. May galaan o magigsunan karong kabuntagon. Salamat sa inyong pakiguban niining dakong buluhaton, CPUC for Christ. Ang Dios bagauban kaninyo ug ato kining padayunon hangtod sa pag-abot di Ginoong Jesus. Amen.
Loved and for
I'm just a sinner saved by grace.
How could I boast on many things I've ever seen or done? How could I dare to claim as mine the victories God has won? Where would I be had God not brought me gently to His face? But I'm here to say that I'm nothing but a sinner saved by grace.
I'm just a sinner. I say, love and forgiven, back with the living. I'm just a sinner saved by grace.
Forever, seek praise.
before magkanta ang Better Men, akong ginahangyong atong mga audience din sa sulod, nga kung mahimo, i-occupy na to ang dunay mga bakante nga mga likuranan sa tubangan. Okay? Na ay mga vacant chairs in front, let us occupy that. So mag-abanti ta so that we can start already. Pagkahuman sa Better Men, doon na tayo processional sa itong program. Pagkahuman ini nga awit. So ako mong ginhangyo, i-occupy na to ang mga vacant chairs kay wala na may lain nga maglingkod ya. Daghang salamat.
Where minds know what it means.
chains, let freedom ring. Wherever hearts know pain,
let freedom echo through the lonely street where prison.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome the Seventh-day Adventist Church world leaders, headed by the General Conference President, Elder Ted Wilson. Shall we all rise and use our flaglets? Ladies and gentlemen, the Philippine National Anthem.
Thank you. Good morning, people of God. Mayong buntag kaninyong tanan, mga minahal ko mga kaigsunan. Nga niya karon dinhi nagatambong ning pinasahing nga kateguman nga ginapasiugdahan sa Central Philippine Union Conference. Salamat sa inyong pagtambong karong adlaw. Kay kini pinasahing adlaw. Og ingon man usab sa atong mga kaigsunan nga naa karon sa inyong mga puluyanan. Members of the church who are just right there in your homes because you cannot come because we have to observe the protocol may tungod sa the number of people who will be joining with us today. So palihog, andama ang inyong mga igdulungog sa pagpamati sa nakanlain ng aming mensahe karong buntaga. It is with great honor to welcome everyone to this great event of Central Philippine Union Conference. How I wish everyone could come to join us, but the pandemic has restricted us in many ways. We thank the Lord for allowing us and our guests to be here and to join us in evangelism launching program we call CPUC for Christ 2021 Season 2. You know, we prayed for this. We planned for this. And God allowed it. Sa di pala ko ipresentar ang atong mga bisita, gusto lako ipadangat ang among kinasingkasing nga kalipay. We would like to extend our heartfelt appreciation to all the leaders, church members throughout Central Philippine Union Conference territory for your full support in evangelism program of the church. I am glad to tell you that the baptism that we have during the pandemic is even higher than compared before the pandemic time. Dalay ko ng Diyos mga kaigsunan, o gani karon tuiga, doon na ta sa about 15,000 souls were already baptized. Oh, we hope that before this year ends, we will reach even 17 to 20,000 souls in his atong territorio sa Central Philippines by the grace of God. Can you say amen? Again. Thank you very much, mga kaigsunan. With us are our special guests. By the way, I would like to request our guest this morning, please come up to the stage. All right? Aron nga inyo makita ang ato mga bisita, akong gihangyo sila nga moanhi sila sa atubangan. All right. Now, first of all, I would like to gladly present to you our mother in the General Conference. Ang atong opisina tuwa sa General Conference, Silver Spring, Maryland, United States of America. Mauni ang atong inahan sa kanunay panabang. Alright, the mother of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, we have Madam Nancy Wilson. Can you raise your hand, Madam? Okay. All right. Ang iyan tapad is Dako. Okay. Then, all right, we have here the Vice President of Adventist World Radio, Pastor Kyle Alam. Pastor Kyle Alam? Okay. Then, another one is the editor of the 360 magazine and travels with Pastor Ted Wilson on all foreign trip to journal the stories that take place. He is no other than Brother Andrew McChesney. And we have here Michael, Brother Michael Dunn. Brother Michael Dunn? All right, the engineer of the Adventist World Radio. Brother Michael Dam. Of course, our very own representative to the division from Central Philippines. He hails from Eastern Samar, Samar Mission of Central Philippine Union Conference, the former IEL India director, now the education director of Southern Asia Pacific Division, Dr. Pastor Bienvenido Mergal. Okay. Thank you. You may not thank you. I would like to request Pastor Ambassador Tejano, please come forward here. At this time, I am so glad to present to you our very own ambassador, His Excellency Ambassador Pastor Bienvenido Tejano, who hails from Northern Samar, Samar Mission of Central Philippine Union Conference. He is an ambassador of the Philippines to Papua New Guinea. He is the Dean of Diplomatic Corps of all the ambassadors in Papua New Guinea. Ambassador Tejano has helped a lot in many ways. We understand how he worked hard. He worked well with the government officials to make things possible for Pastor and Mrs. Ted Wilson's visit to the Philippines and for providing a private plane for the party. Ambassador, the High Excellency Ambassador Pastor Bienvenido Tejano, welcome to Central Philippines. This is your home union. Anyway, thank you so much. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I believe everyone is happy to see our world church leader. He was elected in July 2010 as the president of the General Conference of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. And I cannot forget the first message after his election on that particular Sabbath when he was addressing to the world church, all 70 Adventist members throughout the world, when he was citing the word, "Go forward." Oh, there were many things that he was addressing to us, "Go forward." Ngakakanuna kita magabanti because Christ is coming soon. He is the son of our former General Conference President, Pastor Neil Wilson. He is married to Madam Nancy Wilson.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. What a beautiful rendition from our Adventist Academy of Cebu, the special harmonic youth choir, and this magnificent orchestra. thank you to each one of you who have participated in helping us to be lifted to heaven. What an opportunity to share God's great, amazing grace with others. And what a fitting, beautiful piece to introduce Central Philippine Union Conference for Christ Season 2. What an opportunity to share the amazing grace of Jesus Christ. Thank you, young people, and thank you to the music before them. I was thrilled sitting in the back listening to the music, and this rendition of Amazing Grace is absolutely stellar. Stay close to Jesus, sing and play for Him and His glory, and you will continue to make beautiful music for God. Maayong buntag, ma nga minal minahal kong ma nga kaiksunan. Pastor Katani, I hope they understood me. Pastor Katani is my teacher, you see. He helped me to understand that, but I needed more practice. But what a privilege to be here in Cebu again. This is my second time. To be in this beautiful auditorium on this lovely campus of the Academy. And I understand, brothers and sisters, if I'm not mistaken, Pastor Katani, this is the first time that you have been able to collect and gather as a large group of people in about 20 months. And for that, I say, praise be to God. What a privilege to be together as brothers and sisters. Now, Cebu is famous for many things. It's a big city, big region. You produce some of the most fantastic mangoes in the world, which get exported around the world. And in fact, your union had a very lovely reception last evening for leaders of the union and the conferences, the institutions. They gave us some beautifully packaged dried mangoes. Believe me, we will enjoy them. I also have to tell you, for those of you who like it, I have also enjoyed, while being here, some durian. Now, you know, people either like it or they really don't like it. But I really like it. And I just feel at home when I'm in a place where there are such beautiful tropical fruits. So Cebu is known for many things. But I want to tell you, Cebu is also known for a center of God's influence in the Philippines. Every one of you is part of CPUC for Christ Season 2. There is no one who is left out. Everyone is part of integrated evangelism lifestyle. Everything is coordinated in total member involvement. Everybody doing something for Jesus. Now, I want to thank Pastor Katani and those who have welcomed us so nicely, have brought us into fellowship with you. But Pastor Katani mentioned something at the beginning when he was introducing me, that an emphasis was made, and I make it all the time because it's even truer now than it was in the past. And that is, my brothers and sisters here in Cebu, Jesus is coming soon. That's why we're here today. That's why we're having this special evangelism rally, Ambassador Tejano. And what a privilege it is to have Ambassador and Mrs. Tejano, Ambassador and Dr. Tejano with us. They have done an extraordinary work in helping facilitate our arrival in the Philippines several days ago. Without their intervention, without God working through the ambassador, it would have been impossible for us to be here because of all of the restrictions. But I want to tell you, we had a special mission. One of them is to come and visit with you, and what a privilege it is to be here today in this large auditorium, perhaps one of the largest facilities in the Seventh-day Adventist Church in the Philippines. What a privilege to be able to focus our attention on evangelism. Now, we arrived in the Philippines, and after a few days, we took a trip to Mindoro. Mindoro, as you know, is one of the major islands, territories of the vast Philippine archipelago. In fact, Sister Tejano was telling us as we were flying yesterday, if I'm not mistaken, there are 7,300 islands in the Philippines. Amazing. Now, I suppose maybe a few of them are not inhabited, but most of them have people. That's why evangelism is so important. That's why IEL is so important. That's why TMI is so important. That's why I will go. Yes, Lord, I will go is so important. Well, in Mindoro, something unusual was happening. You may have heard about it. As you know, in certain areas, there are people who have not been cooperative to the government, actually violently opposing. In Mindoro, there has been a rebellious approach for 50, 60 years. The government has tried many different ways to touch the hearts of the people who were rebelling. Now, I want to tell you something. You and I may look like we are law-abiding citizens. We may look like we are composed in our approach to life. We may look like we are conforming to the appropriate habits in life. But I want to tell you, unless Jesus has control of our hearts, we are all rebels. For we are fighting against that which is true and honest and of good report. You know, young people, if you ever have a challenge in front of you, if you're ever tempted to become disillusioned and angry and rebellious, go to Philippians chapter 4 and verse 8, where it tells us to think about those things that are of good report, those things that are honest and true, those things that will lift us up. When you fix your mind on focusing upon Christ and His righteousness and His pure way of living, you will no longer be a rebel. You will be one of Christ's greatest followers. All of us need revival, reformation, repentance, and humility to fall before the Lord and ask Him to control our lives. Yes, Jesus is coming very soon. Things are transpiring in the world to focus our attention on the signs in Matthew 24 and in the book of Revelation, telling us the coming of Jesus is very near. The devil will do everything he can to confuse older ones, younger ones, everyone. That's why, my dear friends, it is absolutely essential to stay close to the Word of God. My dear young friends, especially, those of you here at the Academy and those of you who are living in this immediate area as part of God's people, stay close to His Word. Not to what you read on social media, not to what you hear others saying, well, I think this is what religion is all about, or I think maybe this is the way we ought. No, go to the Bible. The Bible has the answers for our daily living. You know, one of these days, at the very end of time, and we're getting very close, you're going to hear on the news, Jesus has come to Cebu City. He has come to the television station in Cebu City. Go and see Jesus in the center of Cebu City. Don't believe it. Jesus has appeared in Johannesburg, South Africa. He has appeared in Bangkok, Thailand. He has appeared in Moscow, Russia. He has appeared in New York. He has appeared in Manila. Don't believe it. The Bible says when Jesus comes, how many eyes will see him? All eyes, every eye will see him. His coming will be audible, visual, literal. You will see him coming in the clouds, everyone, from this part of the world to the other side of the world at the same time. That's a miracle of God. You will hear him as he shouts out to those who have died in Christ and are raised incorruptible in Jesus. You will hear the trumpet blast. Yes, Jesus will come in the clouds of heaven and he will not touch this earth. But we are told in the book, The Great Controversy, Satan will attempt to counterfeit Jesus' arrival or Jesus' presence. In fact, it goes so far to say that the devil himself, looking like Jesus, performing miracles, providing enthusiastic admonition to people, that he will say, my dear friends, I have changed the day of worship from Saturday to Sunday. And people around you, unless you know your Bible, unless you know how Jesus is coming, unless you know that the seventh day Sabbath is the sign and seal of God on his people, you will be tempted to listen to that counterfeit. And then, can you imagine? People will come up to you. What's the matter with you? Didn't you hear what Jesus said in Cebu City? He said, I changed the day. You don't have ears? You can't see? What's your problem? No, I know what the Bible says. Only by relying upon Jesus every day and listening to his word, reading his word, and allowing God to control you, will you be able to stand in the last days, proclaiming that amazing grace that we just heard. Well, on the island of Mindoro, there were those who were fighting against God, against the nation,
The government, as I said, tried everything. They tried to give them money, they tried to encourage them, they tried to give them land, they tried to resettle them, whatever they could do, nothing worked. But God had a plan. Adventist World Radio, one of our great evangelistic outreach opportunities, began to transmit, broadcast Seventh-day Adventist messages. And you know, AWR, Adventist World Radio, works through all kinds of methods. Internet, podcasts, little devices also that can tell people. They just listen to these devices, all these Bible sermons and wonderful renditions of God's Word. They call them God pods. They use shortwave radio, they use middlewave radio, they use every method possible to touch the hearts of people, including cell phone evangelism. Brothers and sisters, today here in Cebu, as you are part of CPUC for Christ Season 2, use every method possible to share Jesus and His amazing grace. What a privilege to be part of this outreach. Well, Adventist World Radio, AWR, began to share these messages. You know, AWR has messages on good health. Let me tell you, especially young people, don't put stuff into your body that is going to destroy you. Put the right things in, the right food, the right drink, the right thing. Let me tell you, you are part of a great world family, about 22 million brothers and sisters around the world, and in the Philippines, praise God, you have upwards of almost 1.5 million of those 22 million members. Praise God for being part of this great world family. But it doesn't matter whether we're here or whether somehow we lose communication. If you have your Bible or have those truths embedded in your heart, you have everything you need for CPUC Season 2 for Christ. Because your Bible and God's Holy Spirit will lead you to great victories as you share with others. On Sabbath afternoon, Nancy and I and a few others went to another location where we saw another baptism. We went to another location on Mindoro where there had been a baptism of 341 people, and we celebrated with them. And then we went to another place, and we missed something Saturday night at the original site in Rojas. We heard about it. Those former rebels, new creatures in Jesus, put on an extravagant, wonderful program, simple program, but magnificent, in giving witness to all those who were there, testimony as to what Jesus had done in their hearts. And that night, Saturday night, they lit candles around a swimming pool where the meetings were taking place. They committed themselves to winning one more person to Jesus before the end of the year. Now, my dear friends here in this beautiful auditorium, I want to challenge you today, by God's grace, as you move into CPUC for Christ Season 2, to be filled with the Holy Spirit, to pray for the latter rain of the Holy Spirit, to ask the Lord to prepare you for the end of time, and to allow the Holy Spirit to use you in a powerful way to win another soul for Jesus. You know, the prophet Isaiah was a tremendous blessing to God's people. He was not always appreciated by God's people.
He went through very difficult times. In fact, information would lead us to believe that Isaiah was martyred for God. But Isaiah was, in his early experience, challenged with being a part of God's great church and message. In Isaiah chapter 6, it tells about this experience. And Isaiah was taken into vision. In verse 1 of Isaiah 6, it says, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Now I want you to get the picture. So, you know, young people have good imaginations, and the rest of us, we try to keep up. Imagine now in your mind's eye this amazing throne room of heaven. And let me tell you, young people, everyone, older ones, as I prayed in the presence of the governor of Batangas yesterday, prayed for him and his wife Regina, I prayed in there that you have direct access to the throne room of heaven. You don't have to go through anyone except to pray in Jesus' name. You don't have to go through a priest. You don't have to go through Mary. Mary is dead. Let's be very plain about that. There's no such thing as Mary living in heaven and being next to Jesus and kind of interceding for anybody. No. We know what the Bible says about the state of the dead. When you die, it's as if you're asleep. You know nothing. You don't have to go through a saint. You don't have to go through a priest. You don't have to go through anyone to the throne room of heaven. You can go directly to the throne room of heaven right now, every one of you. Praise God. So Isaiah was seeing this throne room of heaven, amazing place. And the Lord was lifted up on a high throne. And his garments, his kingly garments, were so magnificent they filled the entire throne room. Well, Isaiah goes on to tell us what it was like. He said there were angels there, seraphim. They had six wings. Now, I don't know about you, but I have dreams, and I would love to be able to fly. I don't know about you, but that's something for the future, because Jesus says when he comes, we will meet those who have died in Christ where? In the air. That means you and I are going to lift off the ground, and Jesus is going to provide amazing aeronautics for each of us, and we're going to fly to heaven. It's going to take us 7 days to get to heaven. We're going to go through Orion. Everyone in that enormous group of people that the Lord will save over the ages will have a chance, if they haven't had it before, of keeping one Sabbath before they get to heaven. We'll be flying. Well, there are these angels, seraphim. And they have six wings. With two, they cover their face. With two, they cover their feet. And with two, they fly. Now, why would they cover their faces and their feet? Out of great respect for God. I want to thank the people of the Philippines, your culture. And you have many different subcultures in the Philippines. I understand that. You have different languages and different dialects. I understand that. But there is something very special about the people of the Philippines. They show great respect for others, for leaders, for those in authority, for those who are older. Don't ever give up that beautiful characteristic of the Philippines. Show respect. Now, when it comes to showing respect for God, these angels were showing the ultimate respect. And then it says in the Bible, these angels were crying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." If you want something very similar to that language, read Revelation chapter 4. I think there are only 11 verses in chapter 4 of Revelation. Magnificent explanation of how to worship God. And again, I want to compliment this magnificent orchestra. Thank you for playing in a powerful and wonderful way. Now, okay, I see some oboes and flutes, woodwinds, but that's what I play right there. I play the clarinet. So thank you for playing, all of you. That music that you produced is the kind of music that you can hear in heaven, lifting people up to the throne room of heaven. Revelation chapter 4, read it. And it's again, of course, stated here before Revelation in Isaiah. Holy, holy, holy. And the posts of the door, all of this noise and all of this activity, the posts of the door were shaken by the voice of him who cried out, and the house was filled with smoke. I mean, Isaiah was looking at the throne room of heaven. Everything was happening. He was seeing magnificent things. He was hearing unbelievable things. He probably even smelled unbelievable things. The smoke. I mean, smoke smells, okay? This is the throne room of heaven. And Isaiah was feeling smaller and smaller and smaller. And finally he said, verse 5, "Woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips, for my eyes have seen the King." What a privilege it will be to see the King of Kings in heaven. To see him come in the clouds and then to be with him forever. To be with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Yes, there are three distinct persons to the Godhead. They are one, but they are three distinct persons. Can I explain that? No, I accept it by faith. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Just on Sabbath, we used that in baptism. And so here's poor Isaiah feeling so low. Then God knew all along Isaiah needed encouragement, just as you and I need it today. In CPUC for Christ season 2, you need God's Spirit. You need his animating power. You need forgiveness. I need forgiveness. And so the angel already was commissioned to go to the altar, took a coal, and came to Isaiah and touched his lips. Now I want to tell you, those of you in the medical field, and you don't even have to be in the medical field to know this, you do not take a coal from the fire and touch it to the delicate skin of an individual, much less the even more tender skin of the lips. It will burn it. But this was a symbol of God saying, "Isaiah, I am going to cover you with my righteousness. I'm going to give you the power to proclaim." And let me tell you, brothers and sisters, that three angels' powerful tri-message, the three angels' messages, at the very core of those messages is the righteousness of Jesus Christ, his justifying righteousness, his sanctifying righteousness. We owe everything to Jesus Christ for eternal life. We don't earn our way to heaven. We do good works because we're connected with Jesus on a daily basis, reading his word, praying. We are connected to the Lord. That's why you're going to do powerful things in CPUC for Christ. Well, that angel touched the mouth of Isaiah and said to him, "Your iniquity is taken away and your sin purged." Oh, What a fantastic answer to Isaiah. Now I can do something for the Lord because He has forgiven me. He has given me eternal life. He has given me the opportunity of sharing with others. And Isaiah was so excited and so happy. And I don't know about you today, but I am so happy that Jesus has provided His blood, His merits, and His grace to save me and you. Can you say amen? Amen. And so Isaiah was so excited, and he heard a voice of the Lord, the voice of the Lord. Verse 8, whom shall I send, and who will go for us? And immediately Isaiah was so excited, he says, here am I, send me, here I am, Lord, I'm ready to go, I will go. I want to tell you, in the last number of months, we prepared, probably about 3 years ago now, 4 years ago, we prepared strategic plans for the entire world church. The Southern Asia Pacific Division is one of 13 world divisions around the world, the globe. And they have taken those strategic plans, adjusted it for SSD. That's the acronym we call for Southern Asia Pacific Division, SSD. In fact, their motto is so exciting. I like it, the acronym SSD. In administrative terms, it refers to Southern Asia Pacific Division. But they have changed it so SSD represents Seek, Save, Disciple. That's your position, your job in CPUC for Christ Season 2. To seek, to save, and to disciple all through the power of the Holy Spirit. And so Isaiah said, here I am, send me. And as we were developing these strategic plans, we kept the same motto and theme of the last quinquennium, which was reach the world. In other words, let's reach central Philippines. Let's reach everywhere. But we wanted something unique, something personal. We heard about a wonderful motto that young people had come up with. Two young people in Argentina, because they were so excited about mission work, they came up with the motto for a whole lot of other young people, I will go. We contacted the young people in Argentina, said, would you mind if we use that theme for the worldwide strategic plans? Of course, they said, yes, yes, it's okay. But I think they wanted everyone to know that young people came up with that slogan. So I'm telling you today, praise God for young people. Praise God for the Adventist Academy of Cebu. Praise God for young people who are going to be on fire for Jesus. And praise God for those young ladies who are welcoming us this morning in 1 year in mission. Thank you. Thank you for being part of God's great mission. And so that term has now been incorporated into our strategic plans. I will go. So Jesus today is calling you. He's saying, who is going to go for us, for the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit? Who is going to be the one moving from door to door? Who is going to be talking to the person in the park? Who is going to be explaining the Bible at work? Who is going to be doing the work in homes? God is calling you and me. I want to read something from the book Last Day Events, page 75. If you don't know that book, it's a compilation of, obviously, quotations about the last days that Ellen White wrote. And I just want to tell you, the spirit of prophecy is one of God's greatest gifts to the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Young people, read it. you'll be inspired and enthused with what God has in store for you. It says here on page 75, everywhere there is a tendency to substitute the work of organizations for individual effort. Multitudes leave to institutions and organizations the work of benevolence. They excuse themselves from contact with the world, and their hearts grow cold. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, young people, always be helping others. It will make your heart warm and alive. If you stay away from people and stay away from participating in CPUC for Christ, your heart will get cold. It says here they become self-absorbed and unimpressible. Love for God and man dies out of the soul. My dear friends here in Cebu, as you begin and launch CPUC for Christ Season 2, may God help you to always, through His grace, understand what Isaiah understood, that through God's power, you can do all things. As you look to God's word, He will guide you in a powerful way. As you listen to the instructions of the Spirit of prophecy, He will enthuse your hearts for great exploits for Him. As you pray to Him daily, He will animate your heart and make your heart warm as you enlist others in the great, wonderful plan of salvation. For Jesus is coming soon. One of these days, we'll look up into that eastern sky and we'll see a little cloud approaching. It'll be about half the size of a man's hand, and it will get bigger and bigger and brighter and brighter. And soon it will fill the entire sky. All of heaven poured out for this climactic day, the climax of your efforts for CPUC for Christ and your outreach to others. And we'll look up into that cloud and we'll see in the very center of the cloud, Jesus Christ. And we'll say, this is the God whom we have waited for. He will save us. And Jesus will look down and say, well done, good and faithful servants of Central Philippine Union, of the Adventist Academy of Cebu. Well done, good and faithful servants. I like to think he'll personalize it in many ways. Thank you for what you have done to make it possible. And as those make it possible for salvation through the power of God, and as the dead in Christ rise, and then we who are alive rise up together, we'll look around and you will see those whom you have invited to fall at the foot of the cross. You will see them rising together. Oh, what a joyous, wonderful occasion it will be. Right now, Jesus is asking you and you and you, and you, and you, and you, to respond to Him. Are you willing today to say, yes, Lord, I will go. I will be part of this great final proclamation. If you would like to tell the Lord right now, yes, Lord, here I am, send me. I will go. Would you just stand to your feet right now? Amen. Amen. Dear Lord, you see so many people standing, young people, older ones, people who are committed to you. Thank you for the Central Philippine Union, for every conference, every local church, every pastor, every teacher, every literature evangelist, every member. Thank you for the young people. The young people in 1 year in mission, the young people who are out on the streets selling literature, the young people who are involved in integrated evangelism lifestyle, young people who are full of the Holy Spirit. Bless the launching now of this magnificent program, CPUC for Christ, Season 2. Lord, bless each leader and each member. We are saying to you by standing, yes, Lord, I will go. Use me in your service. Thank you for hearing us now, and thank you for the promise of your soon coming. Bless each one here today, their loved ones, their families, and bless those that they're going to be inviting to join in this last day Advent movement. Lord, bless this academy and all of its activities for you. And bless CPUC for Christ, Season 2. We ask all of this in the name of our wonderful and powerful Savior and coming King and best friend, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated.
Mga kaigsunan, beloved members of the church, I have the feeling that we have to show our love response to God today. We are challenged by the message of our beloved president of the General Conference, Elder Ted N.C.